ಆದಿಭ್ಯೋ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮವಿದ್ಯಾ ಸಂಪ್ರದಾಯ ಕರ್ತೃಭ್ಯೋ ಶರ್ಷಿಭ್ಯೋ ಮಧ್ಯೋ ನಮೋ ಗುರುಭ್ಯೋ ಸರ್ವೋಪಪ್ಲವರಹಿತ ಪ್ರಜ್ಞಾನ ಪ್ರತ್ಯಕರ್ತು ಬ್ರಹ್ಮೈವಾಹಮಸ್ಮಿ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮೈವಾಹಮಸ್ಮಿ ನಾರಾಯಣಂ ಪದ್ಮಭೂಮಿಶಿಷ್ಟಂ ಶಕ್ತಿಂಚ ತತ್ಪುತ್ರ ಪರಾಶರಂ ಚ ವ್ಯಾಸಂ ಶುಕಂ ಗೌಡಪದಂ ಮಹಾಂತಂ ಗೋವಿಂದ ಯೋಗೀಂದ್ರ ಮಥಾಸ್ಯ ಶಿಷ್ಯಂ ಶ್ರೀ ಶಂಕರಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಮಥಾಸ್ಯ ಪದ್ಮಪಾದಂ ಚ ಹಸ್ತಾಮಲಕಂ ಚ ಶಿಷ್ಯಂ ದಂತೋಟಕಂ ವಾರ್ತಿಕಕಾರಮನ್ಯಾನ್ ಸ್ಮದ್ಗುರೂನ್ ಸಂತತಮಾನತೋಸ್ಮಿ ಶ್ರುತಿ ಸ್ಮೃತಿ ಪುರಾಣಾನಾಂ ಆಲಯಂ ಕರುಣಾಲಯಂ ನಮಾಮಿ ಭಗವತ್ಪಾದಂ ಶಂಕರಂ ಲೋಕಶಂಕರಂ ಶಂಕರಂ ಶಂಕರಾಚಾರ್ಯಂ ಕೇಶವಂ ಪಾದರಾಯಣಂ ಸೂತ್ರಭಾಷ್ಯಕೃತೌ ವಂದೇ ಭಗವಂತೌ ಪುನಃ ಪುನಃ ಈಶ್ವರೋ ಗುರುರಾತ್ಮೇತಿ ಮೂರ್ತಿಭೇದವಿಭಾಗಿನೇ ವ್ಯೋಮವದ್ವ್ಯಾಪ್ತದೇಹಾಯ ದಕ್ಷಿಣಾಮೂರ್ತಯೇ ನಮಃ. ಓಂ ಸಹನಾಭವತು ಸಹನೌ ಭುನಕ್ತು ಸಹ ವೀರ್ಯಂ ಕರವಾವಹೈ ತೇಜಸ್ವಿನಾವಧೀತಮಸ್ತಮಾವಿದ್ವಿಷಾವಹೈ. ಓಂ ಶಾಂತಿಃಶಾಂತಿಃಶಾಂತಿಃ. ಯದ್ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಗೋಚರ ವಿಚಿತ್ರತಮಃ ಪ್ರಭಾವಾತ್ ಸಂಸಾರದೀಜನಿತ ದುಃಖಮಭೂಜನಸ್ಯ ಯದ್ಬ್ರಹ್ಮದೀಜನಿತ ಸೌಖ್ಯಮಭೂಜ ತಸ್ಯ ತಂ ರುಕ್ಮಿಣೀ ಸಹಿತ ಕೃಷ್ಣಮಹನ್ ನಮಾಮಿ. ಯಮಿಹ ಕಾರುಣಿಕಂ ಶರಣಂ ಗತೋಪ್ಯರೀ ಸಹೋದರಾಪಮಹತ್ಪದಂ ತಮಹಮಾಶು ಹರಿಂ ಪರಮಾಶ್ರಯೇ ಜನಕಜಾಂಕಮನಂತ ಸುಖಾಕೃತಿಂ. ಸೊ we're looking at what is avidya. Same adhyasa that we looked into is called as avidya. Avidya karyatvat avidya iti uchyate. So kar, like the ghata is known as mrut because it is mrut karya. Similarly, adhyasa is also called as avidya because of being avidya or ajnana karya. So tametam evam lakshanam adhyasam. This very adhyasa as defined here and as discussed here, panditas call as, the scholars call as avidya. Further in the tika, nanu brahmajnana nashyatvena sutritam avidyam hitva adhyasa kimiti varnyate ityataha tametam iti. So this was introduced by Bhagavan Vyakhyanakara as with an objection. Brahmajnana nashyatvena sutritam avidyam. The avidya which is in the sutra as what? Brahmajnana nashya avidya. The nanj in avidya is virodharthe. Virodha to what? Virodha to jnana, to vidya. So vidya virodhini avidya. And what kind of virodha is there? It is the virodha which will finally lead to destruction of one or the other. So what will get destroyed? When vidya becomes stronger, avidya will get destroyed. So avidya is vidyanashya. Brahmajnana nashya, Brahmavidya nashya. Therefore, that avidya should be talked about. Avidyam hitva, having oha tyage, having given up, avidya which should be discussed. You are finally going to talk about Brahmajnana, Brahmavidya, and then you are going to say Brahmavidya will take away avidya, thereby moksha, then why not talk about avidya? Why talk about adhyasa? So avidyam hitva adhyasa kimiti varnyate. Why do you talk about? Why is avidya talked about? Why is adhyasa talked about and not avidya? Ityataha tametamiti. So this very adhyasa is called as avidya by those who are in the know. Those who know the shastra, they know that the same adhyasa is avidya karya. Therefore, talking about adhyasa is talking about avidya. Oh, but this is karya, avidya karya. So at the most you can call it as karya vidya, not karana vidya. There is a karana vidya also, mula vidya. In shastra, in your own Advaita shastra, karana vidya is talked about as mula vidya. Why not talk about mula vidya then? Why talk about karya vidya? So akshiptam samahita आक्षिप्तम समाहितम उक्त लक्षण लक्षितम अध्यासम अविद्या कार्यत्वात् अविद्या इति मन्यन्ते इत्यर्थः. Why is this called as avidya, adhyasa? Because it is avidya karya. There is an akshepa. Why? Adhyasa is discussed. So, akshiptam samahitam ukta lakshana lakshitam. That which is the lakshya of the definition given, that adhyasa, giving up that adhyasa, talk about avidya. Siddhanti says, no, the same thing is avidya karya, therefore adhyasa is talked about. So adhyasam avidya karyatvat. Why do you call it as avidya? Because it is avidya karya. This much we have seen anyway. But without looking into the vyakhyana. So manyante ityartha vidya nivartyatvacha asya avidyatvam ityah tad vivekena iti. Further what? It is called as avidya for another reason also. Not only because it is avidya karya, so avidya karyatvat avidya, and also what? Avidya nivartyatvat. Since it goes away by vidya, therefore that nanj is used, and avidya is also the name for adhyasa, because adhyasa as a karya will also go away. Avidya karya will go away once avidya goes away. Therefore, vidyanashyatvat avidya, vidyanashyatvat adhyasopi avidya iti manyante. Adhyasa will also go away when avidya goes away by vidya because of being avidya karya. So karananashina karyanashah. Karyanasha takes place by karananasha. Tathapi. Tadvivekaneti. So in the mula, tadvivekena च वस्तु स्वरूप अवधारणम विद्याम आहुहु. सो तद्विवेकेन तद्विवेकेन च वस्तु स्वरूप अवधारणम. वंस वन इज एबल टू डिस्क्रिमिनेट आत्मा अनात्मा, विवेक टेक्स प्लेस, वस्तु स्वरूप अवधारण टेक्स प्लेस. यू आर एबल टू सेपरेट आउट प्रत्यगात्मा योर ओन स्वरूप फ्रॉम अहंकारादि अनात्मा, देन दी वस्तु ब्रह्म वस्तु इज नोन, विच इज नोन एज वॉट? स्वरूपेण. अवधारणा इज स्वरूपेण. वस्तु इज माई वेरी स्वरूप. दैट वस्तु स्वरूप अवधारणा, अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ आत्मा एज ब्रह्म इज कॉल्ड एज विद्या. विद्या आहुहु, that is called as vidya. So avidya is vidyanashya. What is vidya? Vidya is brahmajnana. And what is that brahmajnana? Through viveka, knowing your own swarupa as the vastu swarupa, brahma swarupa. Tika vyakhyana. Adhyastha nishedena adhishthana. There is some trouble with highlighting it. I hope the mouse is seen anyway, mouse pointer. So, adhyastha nishedhena adhishthana swarupa nirdharanam. Vidyam adhyasa nivartikam ahu ityartaha. So, what is this vidya? Vastu swarupa avadharanam tadvivekena. So, adhyastha nishedhena. Tadvivekena means adhyastha nishedhena. By negating the reality which is lent to the adhyastha ahankaradi prapancha. Whatever is superimposed cannot be real. What is real is the substratum, the adhishthana. So adhishthana swarupa nirdharanam, ascertaining that this is shukti, not rajata. Nedam rajatam shuktika eva. In the exemplified, no, I am not अहंकारादि, I am not मनुष्यादि, I am not पुरुषादि, I am not a संसारी. So अध्यस्त निषेध takes place. नेति नेति, and then कोस्मि, ब्रह्म एव अस्मि. So अधिष्ठान स्वरूप, स्वरूपेण ब्रह्म एव अस्मि, इति निर्धारणम दैट इज विद्या. सो विद्या एंड व्हाट डज इट डू, इट टेक्स अवे अविद्या, देयरफॉर अविद्या कार्य आल्सो एंड देयर बाय अध्यास निवर्तिका. विद्या इज अध्यास निवर्तिका, इट डिस्ट्रॉयज अविद्या एंड अविद्या कार्य विच इज अध्यास, देयरफॉर अध्यास निवर्तिकाम आहुहु, विद्याम आहुहु इत्यर्थः. तथापि कारणाविद्याम, तथापि कारणाविद्याम त्यक्त्वा, दिस मूला विद्या, हैविंग गिवन अप मूला विद्या, कार्याविद्या किमिति वर्ण्यते, व्हाई डू यू टॉक अबाउट कार्याविद्या, व्हाई भगवान भाष्यकार टॉक्स अबाउट कार्याविद्या अध्यास एंड नॉट कारणाविद्या मूला विद्या. बिकॉज व्हाट इज द कारण फॉर संसार दैट यू टॉक अबाउट, that should be destroyed, the root cause should be removed, so moola vidya should be talked about. Why are you talking about karya adhyasa varnyate tatraha tatre iti. So bhashyakaras expect this kind of a purva paksha, tatra evam sati, moola tatra evam sati. So adhyasa being what it is, the way it has been described, adhyasa being what it is, yatra yadadhyasa tat krutena doshena gunena va anumatrena api sana sambadhyate. Adhyasa is mithya. Being mithya, yatra yadadhyasa, yatra yasya adhyasa. In shuktika, rajata adhyasa is there. In rajju, sarpa adhyasa is there. Rajju does not change even a bit. Shuktika does not change even a bit. Wherever the adhyasa is there, that adhisthana does not change at all. The desert water does not wet the desert land. The mirage water does not wet the desert sand at all. Rajju appears like sarpa, so sarpa is adhyastha in Rajju, but sarpa doshas aren't there. There is no visha in Rajju. There is no sarpa guna in Rajju. What about a little bit? The Rajju scraped your leg when you are walking in the forest area. Can there be little poison? Obviously, there cannot be even a little poison because there is no poison in the Rajju. So, tatkrutena doshena gunena va anumatrena api, not even a little. By not even a little, sambadhyate, sana sambadhyate. So, adhisthana has absolutely nothing to do with adhyastha. Okay, but what is the question? The question is, why do you talk about adhyasa and not talk about moola vidya? So the Tikakara says, tatra evam sati yatra yadadhyasa tatkrutena doshena gunena va anumatrena api sana sambadhyate covers that. How so? The Tikakara, the Vyakhyanakara looks at this and says, tasmin adhyase, tatra evam sati means, tasmin adhyase ukta nyayena avidyatmake sati ityartha. When this adhyasa is adhyasa karya itself, the adhisthana being avidyatmaka, the adhyastha being avidyatmaka, adhisthana has nothing to do with adhyastha. So, tasmin adhyase uktanyayena avidyatmake sati ityartha. Being mithya, and since there is no connection of the adhisthana with anything that is adhyastha, including its gunas, because of being avidya. Avidya, atma here is swarupa. Avidya, swarupaka. Adhyasa, swarupa itself is avidya. There is nothing else. Avidya karyatvat. So, tasmin sati. Ityartaha, avidya atmake sati. Moola vidya ha. Why moola vidya is not talked about and why adhyasa has karya vidya talked about? Moola vidya has shushuptav anarthatva adarshanat. when you go to sleep, when the karyadhyasa is not there, that is the idea. When is mula vidya seen as functional? In Sushupti, is it seen as functional? No. In Jagratavastha, is it seen as functional? In Swapnavastha, is it seen as functional? When do you have trouble? You may have trouble throughout the waking state. Prarabdha may not be good enough. You want to just get over with the day. Then unfortunately, since we have avoided our daily prarabdha, avoided in sense we have tried to run away, it manifests in Swapnavastha also. So we get nightmares instead. Just taking the worst case scenario. So we are not able to sleep well also. The dream troubles. But what do we want to do? We do not want those dreams also. We want to avoid those and go to deep sleep. Why do we want to go to deep sleep? Is because there is no adversity. There is no issue in deep sleep. In Sushupti Avastha, we don't have any afflictions of the Jagrat and Swapna Avastha. Even the worst of the pain goes away in the deep sleep. So is Mula Vidya there? Very much there. Otherwise, we would be Jnani. We will wake up as Jnani. But an Ajnani wakes up as an Ajnani. Samsari wakes up as a Samsari. Then Mula Vidya is there in Sushupti Avastha. Why is Mula Vidya not talked about? Because Mula Vidya is creating no trouble in Sushupti Avastha. By itself, Mula Vidya is not harming us at all. In fact, we wake up happy. We may not be happy to wake up. We may snooze the alarm because there is Ananda in Sushupti Avastha. Swarupa Ananda is manifest. It is hidden during, but it is still manifest in the Bija Avastha of the Antakarana. So, why is Mula Vidya not discussed? Because it has absolutely no basis to cause trouble in Sushupti Avastha. When is it causing trouble? When it is manifest, meaning when there is Mula Vidya Karya. Karya Vidya Adhyasa is the troublemaker. We have trouble with Adhyasa. Taking Adhyasa as real. This Mula Vidya, although Mula Vidya is the root cause, still by itself it is not causing trouble at that time when only Mula Vidya exists. But without Mula Vidya going, Adhyasa won't go away. And without Adhyasa going away, we will continue to have Samsara, which is Dukkha Rupa. Primarily. Therefore, Adhyasa has to be discussed. Mula Vidya discussion is not going to give us anything. What is the Swarupa of Mula Vidya? It is Vidya Virodhini, it is Vidya Nivartya. Other than that, what can you talk about there? Trigunatmika, Trigunatmika Maya. Then further you can talk about it as what? Sarasad Bhinna. Sadvilakshana, Asadvilakshana. What else can you talk about? You can say it is Karyanumiya because there is nothing other than Nirguna Brahma. And still we find ourselves who are Swarupena, Nirguna Brahma, Satchidananda, Swarupena, Satchidananda Tattva. And still we find ourselves as Samsari. So Karya is not possible, this Prapancha and Samsari status is not possible unless there is something which is Karana. Therefore, Karyanumeya, Maya, Avidya, Mula Vidya, this much we can talk about. Beyond this, what can you talk about? How does it help us? What helps us is, how will the Karya go? Therefore, Adhyasa as Karya Vidya is discussed here. So, Mula Vidya ha Sushuptav Anarthatva Adarshanat. Since we don't see any anartha in Sushupti, although Mula Vidya is continuing, as it is, still Karyatmana Tasyaha Anarthatva Jnapanartham Tadvarnanam Iti Bhavaha. So, Kimiti Karya Vidya Varnyate Natu Karana Vidya Mula Vidya. Mula Vidya is not causing any trouble. How do I know? In Sushupti, only Mula Vidya is there. It does not cause any trouble. In fact, I am happy to go to sleep. Every prani is happy to go to sleep because there is no trouble in Samsarityam continues, but there is no trouble. There is no solution for Samsarityam in Sushupti Avastha, but at least the waking state and dream state troubles aren't there. They won't go away on their own. So you have to work in Jagrat Avastha towards taking away the troubles in life, and that is due to Samsarityam status, which itself is attained due to Avidya Karya, Adhyasa being Avidya Karya, and therefore Karyatmana. Karyatmana means Adhyasa Rupena. Tasyaha eva avidyayaha mula vidyayaha karyatmana. As karya, as adhyasa, tasyaha karya vidyayaha anarthatva jnapanartham. To show that there is anartha only when it starts functioning, it starts acting, other than the will, it starts creating vikshepa also. That happens in dream state and waking state. In dream state, there is no sadhana possible. Meaning, if you are really free in dream, in waking, you still have to be free. So, anyway, those who do a lot of sadhana, japa, ityadi in waking, it continues in dream also. So, it does help. Not that it doesn't help, but then still, you have to be free in the waking state. That itself may trigger, of course. There may be some rare case where jnana is attained in Swapnavastha, but it has to be verified in the Jagratavastha. But that's an aside. Finally, Mula Vidya does not cause any trouble. Vikshepa is in waking state where it causes trouble as Karya Vidya, as Adhyasa. Therefore, Adhyasa is talked about. तद्वर्णनम अध्यासवर्णनम इति भावः अध्यस्त कृत गुणदोषाभ्याम अधिष्ठानम न लिप्यते इति अक्षरार्थ. Whereas भगवान भाष्यकारा स्टेटमेंट लिटरली मीन्स ओनली दिस मच. अध्यस्त कृत गुणदोषाभ्याम अधिष्ठानम न लिप्यते इति अक्षरार्थ. लिटरली इफ यू टेक द मीनिंग देन व्हाट ही सेज इज दैट अधिष्ठाना इज नॉट अफेक्टेड बाय gunas and doshas of the adhyasta. However, implied meaning is also this. The adhyasa does not affect the adhishthana. Mula vidya further removed from affecting the adhishthana. But adhyasa does cause trouble in the waking because of tadatmya sambandha. Adhishthana has tadatmya sambandha, and then there is trouble. Therefore, adhyasa is discussed, it's an implied meaning. Evam adhyasasya lakshana sambhavane uktva pramanamaha. Now the pramanabhashya proper starts as to lakshana being given and sambhavana being given. What remains is to establish the possibility of adhyasa. So, adhyasa lakshana definition has been given. Adhyasa sambhavana has also been given. This is a dvivachana, lakshana sambhavane uktva. Dvitiya Dvivachana. The definition and possibility of Adhyasa. Initially, the Purva Pakshi was saying it is impossible. With examples and Tarka, possibility has been shown. So, he has to say it is possible, but show me how. So, that Pramana has to be shown now. Uktva Pramanamaha Tametamiti. Mula. Tamyetam avidyakhyam, that very adhyasa called as avidya. Avidya iti akhyayasya adhyasasya saha adhyasaha avidyakhyaha. Tam avidyakhyam adhyasam etam, this which has been discussed right now. That very adhyasa which has been discussed right now, also called as avidya because of being an avidyakarya and because it goes away by vidya. That very adhyasa atmanatmanoho itaretara adhyasam puraskrutya sarve pramana prameya vyavahara laukikaha vaidikascha pravruttaha. So that which is called as avidya, that very adhyasa. And what is it? What adhyasa of what on what? Between what there is an adhyasa, atma anatmanu. Atma has adhyasa of anatma and anatma has adhyasa of atma. But at least anatma is adhyasta in atma. This much has to be accepted right now as a possibility. Why so? Because all vyavaharas are there. There is a hetu garbha visheshana here. Puraskritya adhyasam puraskritya avidyakhyam atmanatmanoho adhyasam puraskritya. The adhyasa precedes any vyavahara. Sarve vyavaharaha. Which vyavaharaha? Pramana prameya vyavahara. The pramata is there, who becomes a pramata only after adhyasa. Without adhyasa, there cannot be pramatrutvam. The triputi of pramana, prameya, pramata is possible only when there is adhyasa. Why? Because ahankaradi, antakkarana, one role being ahankara, ahankara being taken as oneself, tadatmya adhyasa. Without the tadatmya adhyasa taking place, arthadhyasa and jnanadhyasa, that I am this individual, this kind of a person, a man, a woman, a student, a teacher, an engineer, a doctor, a servant, a king, whatever, a devata, rakshasa, and then by extension pashu, ityadi, pakshi, ityadi. Before any vyavahara takes place, there has to be an individuality. That individuality is the status of pramatrutvam. I am a pramata, I know. I know that I know further, but that is later, but I know. Every prani has this cognition, I know, which will be shown further. So, puraskritya, adhyasam puraskritya, sarve pramana prameya vyavahara. Once you become a pramata, then you have separated yourself as an individual from everyone else. Having done so, then tools can be used to connect with the objects. So, indriya vyavahara is possible, pramana vyavahara with the vishaya outside, with antakkarana, vishaya inside, whether it is laukika or shastriya, vaidika. So, sarve pramana prameya vyavaharaha pravruttaha. All these vyavaharas are possible, are being done, are done, whether they are laukika, worldly or vaidika, related to the Vedas. In vaidika also what? Whether they are karmakanda or upanishad. All vyavaharas. So, pramana, prameya, pramata, triputi is possible only when adhyasa is possible. So, this is hetu for adhyasa. Without this, adhyasa is not possible. So, arthapatti pramana, anyatha anupapatti pramana has been used to establish this by Bhagavan Bhashyakara. Sarvani cha shastrani, vidhi pratisheda moksha parani. So, all these shastras are also. Shastras also are pravruttaha. So, shastrani pravruttani. Shastras also are engaging one who has adhyasa. Shastra says, you do this, there is a vidhi. Says, you do not do this, there is a nishedha. Shastra says, shravana manana nididhyasana should be done. By whom? Swarga kamo yajeta. One who has kama in swarga, to attain swarga, in that kind of bhoga, he should do yaga. One who does not want narakavasa should not do shenadi karma. So, pratisheda. Mahimsya sarvani bhutani. Nisheda vakya. Towards whom? Towards one who keeps on doing himsa to others by considering himself as one. So individuality is accepted there. Swarga is separate from me. In the Vidhi also, it is accepted that Swarga is separate from me. So individuality is already accepted. That Adhyasa is already accepted and having accepted. Adhyasam Puraskritya. All the Vyavahara, all the transactions, worldly or Karmakanda or Upanishad study also, all those are considering Adhyasa as given. Shastras also, they say Swarga Prapti is there for one who has Adhyasa. Narakavasa is possible for one who has Adhyasa. Moksha is possible for one who is Baddha because there is Adhyasa. So this is a given. It may not be seen by you, the Purvapakshi, but it is clear as day to us, because without an individuality, no Shastra can tell you what you should do, because you think yourself as Karta. Shastra talks about some bhoga to be had, Swarga, by Vidhi, and says that Naraka should be avoided because bhoga should be avoided, you being a Karta. Such bhoga, dukkha rupa bhoga, should be avoided. Naraka should be avoided by pratisheda vakya, considering pratisheda prohibitions. Then, wo atyantika dukkha nivritti and nitya sukha prapti, I want that. So, Shastra says, do shravanam, shravanadi. So, moksha, committed to moksha also. Parani, para is commitment. What is Shastra committed towards? Vidhi, Pratisheda and Moksha. Karma Kanda shows Vidhi, Pratisheda and Moksha is in Upanishads. Jnana Kanda. All of these consider you as an individual. And that individuality is only when Ahankara Adi Prapancha is Adhyastha. Meaning Ahankara is Adhyastha in Brahma, thereby making that Brahma as though jiva, samsari, and adipadena, all the other things outside the sharira, the bhuta bhautika sharira, which is sentient and insentient, again, they are superimposed in Brahma, creating other jivas and the prapancha. Thereby, there is subject-object division, thereby there is limitation, thereby there is pursuit of happiness in one way or the other, for Purnata, and it has been continuing so, Anadikalena. So, Shastras are also dealing with this very Adhyasa. They are dealing with everything, considering this Adhyasa as a given. Tika, Vyakhyana says, Tam etam, avidyakhyam adhyasam puraskritya. So tam varnitam, that which has been discussed. Etam, what is this now? Again, tam etam, that very adhyasa which is discussed in the adhyasa vashya thus far. And etam means etat, this very, that shows pratyaksha anubhava of adhyasa. Aham manushya iti adhyasa, aham karta bhokta iti adhyasa, that is well known to everyone. Prasiddha. You may not consider that to be adhyasa, but that is adhyasa. Do you have anubhava of aham manushya? It is adhyasa. Do you think you are aham purusha, aham stri? Adhyasa. How do you know? Anubhava siddha, I know. How do I know? Sakshi pratyaksha. So that is sakshi pratyaksha. How do you know anything? Ghatam aham janami. There is a ghata outside. There is a pata outside. I know. I know because my eyes are connected to the ghata and I have no choice but to know, as long as my mind is alert. It is not wandering. As long as it is backing the chakshu, then the chakshu, chakshurindriya and ghata, vishaya, sannikarsha takes place. Pramana, prameya vyapara takes place. The pramata knows. I, the pramata, know. There is no choice there. Because it is vastu tantra. Ghata reveals itself. in the wake of Indriya being corrected, Ghatakara Vritti takes place, and then the very role of Chakshur Indriya is to connect the Antakkarana and the Vritti to take place. Vritti takes away the Tula Vidya there, which has been veiling the Ghata, and then the Chaitanya underlying the Ghata and Chaitanya in the Vritti, there is Abheda between them. And then, since I am having this Antakkarana, I am the very Chaitanya which reflects in this Antakkarana Vritti also, thereby I light up the Vritti, and then I claim Ghatamaham Janami. But how do I know that I have known the Ghata? How do I know that I know the Ghata? For the Vritti, there is no other Vritti. For the Ghata to be revealed, there is a Vritti. But for me to know that I know the Ghata, there is no other Vritti. No other Vritti in the sense, there is no Antakkarana Vritti. The Pramata doesn't know. The Pramata doesn't light up. There is a Vritti, all right. But I, as Sakshi Chaitanya, reveal the knowledge. Any knowledge that takes place, whether it is Ghata Jnana or Atma Jnana, Manushya, Aham Manushya Iti Jnana, Aham Iti Pratyaya, Asmat Pratyaya, or Ghatakara Vritti, where Ghatam Aham Janami. In both cases, neutrally, the Sakshi lights up the Vritti. What kind of Vritti? Any Vritti. Any Jnana is known by Sakshi. Ghata is known by the Pramata, but the Ghata Jnana is known by the Sakshi, who is Pramatra Abhinna really. Antakkarana is the Upadhi for the Sakshi, and Antakkarana is the Visheshana for the Jiva Pramata. So, Tam Varnitam Etam Sakshi Pratyaksha Siddham Adhyasam Puraskritya. What is this Etam? Etam is Sakshi Pratyaksha Siddham. I know that I am Manushya, I am Karta. I have knowledge that I am a Karta. I have knowledge that I am a Manushya. How do I know? Because I am a Sakshi. Sakshi Pratyaksha Siddham. There is no doubt about this. Puraskritya Hetum Krut. Puraskritya means Hetum Krutva. Keeping that as a basis, accepting that as the fundamental basis, as an axiom. Whenever Shastra talks about, Shastra doesn't say that, are you a Karta? Oh, then you do this. It assumes that you are a Karta. You can say, I am not a Karta and not do it. So you have a choice. Kartum, akartum, anyathava kartum, shakyate. You have a choice to do, not do, or do it in one way or the other. If Shastra says, you can offer this or that, if you have a choice, you can offer one of the two, you have a choice. You have a choice not to offer, meaning not to do the yaga at all. Only if you are a Karta, you are being talked to by Vedas. If you are not a Karta, the Karmakanda has no business to talk to you. Therefore, Shruti does not have to say, there is Adhyasa, oh, you are a Karta, now you do. You are taken as a Karta for granted, and then Hetum Krutva, Puraskritya is Hetum Krutva. That very Adhyasa, as Manushyoham Ityadi, Hetum Krutva, Laukikaha, Vyavahara. What are these Laukikaha? Laukikaha, Karma Shastriyaha. Moksha Shastriyaschaiti, Trivido Vyavahara Pravartate Ichyartaha. So Bhagavan Bhashyakara says Laukika and Vaidika. Vaidika is what? Karma Shastriya and Moksha Shastriya. Karma Kanda and Jnana Kanda. Both Vyavaharas are included in Vaidika Vyavahara. And Laukika is anyway worldly Vyavahara, all sorts of worldly Vyavaharas. So Trividaha in Vaidika, Bhagavan Vyakhyanakara says you read Karma Vyavahara and Moksha Vyavahara. Vaidika, Karma and Karma Shastra and Moksha Shastra. And whatever they deal with are Shastriya. So the Shastra, Shastra Sambandhi Shastriya, Karma Shastriya and Moksha Shastriya. That which Karma Kanda deals with and that which moksha kanda or jnana kanda deals with, plus laukika, they are three. Trividaha vyavahara pravartate ityartha. Among these, tatra, see, laukika, earlier what has been said in the mula, pramana prameya vyavahara. What is this vyavahara? Pramana prameya vyavahara. This is an upalakshana. Laukika vyavahara is what? I am a pramata. There is a prameya ghata outside. And pramana chakshur indriya can be used to see the ghata. And so on with each and every indriya as pramana. So the triputis can be seen as pramana, prameya and pramatru. Triputi. In the case of karma, being a pramata is no longer sufficient. You should have knowledge about which karma to be done, what is the phala, how should it be done. So all three you should know, but then you should also do it. Therefore, karta, karana and karma. This is the triputi. What is to be done, through what it should be done and who should do it. So there is a triputi there. In moksha shastra, you have to know. So jnana is needed. So jnata, jnana and jneya. Jneya brahma. What should you know through? So shravanadi jnanena. Jnanena brahma, jnana and jnanena moksha. Moksha is to be achieved. Who has to achieve it? The jnata. Jnata will get it. So the triput is jnatru, jnana and jneya. So there is triputi in all three. Trividho vyavahara pravartate ityartha. Tatra vidhi nisheda parani karma shastrani rugvedadini. So rugveda, yajurveda, samaveda, atharveda, these are all vidhi nisheda parani. They prescribe something, they prohibit something else. Primarily vidhi nisheda is the swarupa of Vedas. Rugveda, karma shastra. Also there is upasana, upasana kanda. How should you do something for some particular result to become devata ityadi or to get some kind of a siddhi or whatever it is. So upasanas are also there. They are part of karma shastra also and some part in Upanishads also. So Rigvedadi are karma shastras. Vidhi nisheda shunya pratyak brahma parani. Where there is no vidhi or nisheda. Vidhi or nisheda is possible only in the case of a karta. When the shastra, the section of the Vedas which says that you are not a karta, it doesn't say you are a karta. In the karmakanda, it doesn't say you are a karta. It says that if you want this, meaning you are already taken as a karta. Because if you want this means, I want some bhoga. Who can have bhoga? Only a bhokta can have bhoga. So having taken yourself as bhokta indicates you are a karta also. Therefore, what can you do to become that kind of a bhokta? You have to become a particular kind of karta. You should do some particular things. Those are described in detail then, so that those bhogas detailed can be had. In the jnana kanda though, what you have taken yourself for granted, Shruti says, pause there. Think over. Are you a karta? You are not a karta. So if you are not a karta, then where can be a possibility of vidhi and nisheda? Although by Mimamsa we say Shrotavya is a vidhi. Because it is a technical analysis, there it is a vidhi. If you are not a karta, you cannot have a vidhi. But you cannot jump the gun. In which manner am I not a karta? To understand that there is a vidhi. So considering that the lakshya is I want to become an akarta from being a karta, and I cannot become an akarta if I am really a karta. So rupena if I am a karta, then I can never become akarta. So Shruti is going to reveal that your swarupa is akartrutvam. Akarta is your very swarupa. To know that there is a vidhi given to this hypothetical karta, assumed karta, to him there is a vidhi, shrotavya, mantavya, nididhyasitavya iti. So that atma darshana takes place. Atma va hare drashtavya. So tatra vidhinisheda parani karma shastrani rugveda adini. In those them, at the end, in Rigveda ityadi, Upanishads are also there, Jnana Kanda, which are what? Vidhinisheda shunya. So vidhinisheda shunya pratyak brahma parani. They are committed to what? They are not committed to karma, they are committed not even to upasana, even if it is there. They are committed via upasanas for sthirata. Upasanas may be prescribed, and via upasanas they are committed to jnana, which is pratyak brahma, aikya. So they are committed to brahma, which is non-different from pratyagatma. Therefore, pratyak brahma parani moksha shastrani. It's a moksha shastra. And these moksha shastras, Vedanta vakyani iti vibhaga. What are those? Those are Vedanta. Anta is at the end also literally. But Bhagavan Bhashyakara says elsewhere, anta. Vedanam antaha nischayaha. Anta is nischaya. What is the ascertained conclusion of the Vedas? What are they committed towards? That is Vedanta. Vedanta vakyani iti vibhaga. Evam vyavahara hetutvena adhyase pratyaksha siddhi api. In vyavahara, adhyasa is definitely the hetu. Vyavahara hetutvena adhyase pratyaksha siddhi api. Although it is pratyaksha gochara to everyone. Everyone knows that I am a manushya and further on. Still, they may not consider it as adhyasa. We say we have already defined. We have already defined this is adhyasa. So there is no reason to not accept that there is adhyasa. But still, no, how so? There can be a question, how so? How is this possible? It is pratyaksha siddha. To you also, you know that you are a manishya, you are a karta. You think yourself as a limited being, as a samsari, that is adhyasa. It is anuho siddha, sakshi pratyaksha siddha. Still, evam vyavahara itutvini adhyase pratyaksha siddhe sati api. Pramana antaram pruchyati. No, give me another pramana. Yeah, I have anubhava that I am manushya. I am manushya, but you tell me another pramana for adhyasa. Katham punariti. Mula. So, katham punaha avidyavad vishyani pratyakshadini pramanani shastrani chaiti. If that be the question, I have told you it is anubhava siddha, let's close the argument. No, you show me logically how is it. Show me. How, what do you know about my anubhava? So, Purvapakshi can argue, you know, that how do you say it is anubhava siddha? Show me with anubhava siddha is no pramana here. I have Rajju Sarpa Anubhava also. You yourself say that Anubhava is no good. So you have to refute the Anubhava by another Pramana. By Rajju Darshana as a Pramana, you refute the Sarpa Anubhava. Similarly here, you say Sakshi Pratyaksha Siddha, all that. Give me a Pramana to refute my understanding of Manushya. Manushyattvam, I am a manushya. How is this an adhyasa? Show that with a different pramana, not by my anubhava. Don't use my anubhava against me. So this is the question. If this be the question, katham punaha avidyavad vishyani pratyakshadini pramanani shastrani cha, and now you have gone ahead and said all shastras are also like that. They also consider avidya as adhyasa as hetu. For all vyavahara, and then they are pravrutta, they are engaged. They deal with vidhi and nisheda towards a person who takes himself as a karta. And all these vyavaharas are considering adhyasa as already there, as being already there. Katham punaha avidyavad vishyani. Now this is a bahuri compound. Vishaya is I think ghai pratyanta. Let me just cross check that. Adhare ghai. So by taking adhare घंज प्रत्यय just wanted to cross check it I forgot it so vishaya want to give another ach is also ghai family so aadhare ach is possible so vishaya like ghai ach also pratyaya gives a pullinga nitya pullinga vishaya we have seen earlier also vishaya in english you translate as object sometimes subject matter etc so vishaya is a loaded word So the vyutpatti has to be seen here. Vishaya can be aadhare ghai also. Generally ghai pratyaya or ach pratyaya comes in bhave, bhave karmani. Sometimes as aadhara also, saptami arthe. So here we'll see in the vyakhyana how this is dealt with, how this compound is explained. It's a bauri. Puna avidya vad vishayani. प्रत्यक्षादीनि प्रमाणानि शास्त्राणि चेति सो विषयाणि दैट इटसेल्फ शोज अस विषय इज अ पुल्लिंग विषयाणि इज नपुंसकलिंग इट कैनॉट बी बिकॉज ऑफ अच बीइंग नित्य पुल्लिंग लाइक घी प्रत्यक्षादीनि प्रमाणानि प्रमाणानि इज न्यूटर विशेषण टू दैट इज एज इन व्हाट काइंड ऑफ प्रमाणास प्रत्यक्ष इत्यादि प्रत्यक्ष अनुमान अर्थापत्ति उपमान शब्द शब्द सो ऑल दीज फॉर नैयायिका 4 फॉर वेदांतिन्स 6 अनुपलब्धि ऑल्सो 6 प्रमाण सो प्रत्यक्ष अनुमान उपमान अर्थापत्ति अनुपलब्धि एंड शब्द प्रमाण दीज आर दी 6 प्रमाण प्रमाणानि नपुंसकलिंग शास्त्राणि चेति शास्त्र इज ऑल्सो नपुंसक सो प्रमाणानि शास्त्राणि चेति कथं पुनः अविद्यावद् विषयाणि दिस प्रत्यक्षादीनि प्रमाणानि एंड शास्त्र ऑल्सो प्रमाण शास्त्राणि दे आर अविद्यावद् विषयाणि सो अविद्यावद् विषयाणि हैज टू बी बहुरि सो अविद्यावद् विषयः येषां ते अविद्यावत् विषयाणि येषां प्रमाणानां तानि प्रमाणानि अविद्यावत् विषयाणि दोज विच हैव अविद्यावत् विषय फर्दर विल सी इन द व्याख्यान हाउएवर द पूर्वपक्षी इज आस्किंग हाउ कैन दे बी अविद्यावत् विषय नाउ दिस एज एन आंसर वी लुक एट इन द टीका इन द व्याख्यान हाउ दिस अविद्यावत् विषयाणि इज इंटरप्रिटेड उच्यते द आंसर इज बीइंग गिवन बट लेट्स लुक एट द क्वेश्चन प्रॉपर इन द व्याख्यान कथम पुनः इति अविद्यावान अहम सो अविद्यावद विषयाणि व्हाट डज इट मीन रियली इज दैट विच इज अविद्यावत मतुप अविद्या अस्य अस्मिन् वा अस्ति इति मतुप अविद्यावत विल बी द प्रातिपदिक वन हु हैज अविद्या That which has avidya, avidyavat. In pullinga, it will become avidyavan. And avidyavat vishyani has been mentioned. So avidyavan aham iti adhyasavan atma pramata sah vishayah ashrayah yesham tani avidyavat vishyani iti. So the bahuri is what? Avidyavat vishyani is bahuri avidyavat. विषयः येषां प्रमाणानां तानि प्रमाणानि अविद्यावद् विषयाणि मीनिंग दोज विच हैव अविद्यावत् एज विषय दोज प्रमाणास एंड शास्त्रास दोज प्रत्यक्षादि प्रमाणास एंड शास्त्रास विच हैज अविद्यावान एज अ विषय मीन्स व्हाट आधारे घई आश्रय सप्तमी अर्थे अधिष्ठान So avidyavan, one who has avidya, he has these pramanas as vishayas. Those pramanas, pratyakshadi pramanas and shastras have avidyavan as vishaya. And vishaya meaning what? As ashraya. Because saptami arche adhare ach. So avidyavan is the vishaya, is the ashraya, meaning these pramanas and shastras have ashraya in this avidyavan, this person who has avidya. Pramata. Pramata is the ashraya for these pramanas, pratyakshadi pramanas, who himself is avidyavan. And being avidyavan, he is what? Having adhyasa. That pramatrutvam is an adhyasa. So avidyavan aham iti adhyasavan. I have avidya, I do not know this. So what do I need? I need pramana. Oh, I don't know this prapancha. I need pramana. Which pramana do I need? Pratyakshadi pramanas. What are the pratyakshas? All the indriyas. What is anumana? Based on this pratyaksha. What is upamana? Again based on pratyaksha. What is arthapati? Also based on pratyaksha and anumana. Anupalabdhi, also pramana, based in ashrita in this avidyavan purusha who does not know. If he knew, then he does not need any pramana. A brahmajnani does not need shastra as pramana. One who knows everything does not need anything as a pramana. These pramanas are necessary for one who has avidya. The pramana will take away, will give prama and take away ajnana. Therefore, pramanas are useful for which kind of a person? One who has avidya, obviously. So taking that basic understanding, this compounding has been done as to avidyavad vishyani, pramanani shastrani cha. Pramanas, all the pramanas, laukika vyavahara need laukika pramana, shastriya vyavahara need shastriya pramana. So these shastras and pratyakshadi pramanas, these are resting in this individual. Because he needs it. Why does he need it? Because he has avidya. Whichever vishaya is unknown, he uses an appropriate pramana to know that vishaya, to take away the avidya regarding that vishaya. Therefore, he is avidyavan. So, avidyavan aham, he knows that in any case, I have no vidya, ghata, so ghata avidya is there in me. I don't know what is Brahma, so Brahma avidya. Brahma is the vishaya for that avidya. And therefore, I am an ajnani, I am a avidyavan. So, avidyavan aham, what is this again? Brahma is shuddha chaitanya chidrupa jnanarupa. Jnanarupa Brahma cannot be atma, brahmatma, jnanarupa brahmatma cannot be having ajnana. So, having ajnana or avidya while being Brahma swarupa, that avidya is also adhyasta. So, avidyavan aham iti adhyasavan atma. That brahmatma, which cannot have ajnana, which cannot have avidya because of being the very jnana swarupa. Satyam jnana vanantam brahma. That jnana swarupa brahmatma considers oneself as having ajnana or avidya. Therefore, that is adhyasa. Iti adhyasavan atma. That atma is called as pramata. Avidya is there anadikalena. But when does this brahma become pramata, jiva? When there is karya vidya, manifestation as adhyasa, o avidyavanaham. I know that I have avidya, I am a baddha jiva. It will not go away. As long as avidya does not go away, I will be a samsari. So, adhyasavan atma pramata. And that pramata purusha is a vishaya. Vishaya is adhare ach ashrayaha. Yesham ashraya. For pramanas, he is an ashraya now. He is going to use them to take away avidya. Yesham pramananam tani pramanani. Shastrani cha. They are what? They are avidyavad vishyani. Meaning what? Simple. Pramanas, pratyakshadi pramanas and shastras are those which have ashraya in this avidyavan purusha. Iti vigraha. This is the vigraha vakya.
तत्तत् प्रमेय व्यवहार हेतुभूतायाः प्रमायाः अध्यासात्मक प्रमात्राश्रितत्वात् प्रमाणानाम् अविद्यावत् विषयत्वं यद्यपि प्रत्यक्षम्। नाउ दिस इज प्रत्यक्ष टू एवरीवन। व्हाट इज प्रत्यक्ष? तत्तत् प्रमेय व्यवहार हेतुभूतायाः प्रमायाः। The prama is needed for one who has avidya. Otherwise, I don't need any knowledge if I already have knowledge. Valid knowledge is needed only if I have erroneous knowledge or I don't have any knowledge. By consideration, say that, oh, I don't know about this, I don't have any knowledge. This is the vyavahara. As in, we use such language. Oh, I'm ignorant, I don't know. I know erroneously. In the case of Atma, I know erroneously. So, tat prameya vyavahara hetubhutaya prama. So, prama, tat prameya vyavahara hetubhutaya pramaya. Prama, for the prama to act, what is the hetu? There is some vyavahara which is going on. Prameya vyavahara, I need to know something which is knowable. Prameya is that object which is knowable. So, tat means each and every case. In each and every case, every vyavahara that you have to know something, to interact with something, tat prameya vyavahara hetu bhutaya pramayaha adhyasatmaka pramatra ashritatvat. See, the vyavahara leads to prama. I may have said it other way around. So tat prameya vyavahara hetu bhutaya pramayaha. What does this vyavahara show? What is vyavahara? What does vyavahara need? The vyavahara is for prama. But what does it need? It needs something that is unknown. Adhyasa has to be accepted there. Avidya has to be accepted. And in the exemplified case, avidya vanaham, that itself is adhyasa. So adhyasa has to be accepted. And it is pratyaksha siddha. प्रत्यक्षम यद्यपि प्रत्यक्षम। व्हाट इज प्रत्यक्ष देर? प्रमायाः प्रमेय व्यवहार हेतुभूताय तत्तत् प्रमेय व्यवहार हेतुभूताय प्रमायाः अध्यासात्मक प्रमात्र आश्रितत्वात्। सिंस दिस प्रमाण एंड प्रमेय प्रमा वेयर विल इट वर्क? इट विल वर्क इन अ प्रमाता। यू हैव टू बी अ प्रमाता फॉर प्रमा टू टेक प्लेस इन यू, for pramana prameya vyavahara to take place in you or in and through you. So this prama takes place only for a pramata. Prameya is there only for a pramata. The vyavahara of the prama with prameya and pramana with prameya is possible only for a pramata. They all rest on the pramata. They cannot work independently in the absence of pramata. So pramata has to be there. He is the basis. They are all resting upon, they are all dependent upon this pramata. So pramata is the ashraya. Adhyasatmaka pramatra. And this pramata is what? He should have avidya. This prameya is something to be known. Who can know it? The pramata. Does he already know it? If he knows it, he does not need prama. That means he does not know. Meaning he has avidya. And that he can know, that he is a pramata, is an adhyasa. Because he is what? He cannot be avidyavan. Prameya is an object to be known. Prama is that is valid knowledge which will come out of pramana prameya vyavahara. He needs to use pramana to interact with prameya so that prama takes place. The knowledge will arise when you use the right tools to interact with the object. If the chakshur indriya sees the ghata jnana, ghata prama will take place. For that, I should necessarily be a pramata, meaning I should be a pramata by not knowing the prameya. I don't know the prameya vastu right now. Only then I'll use the pramana. So I am avidyavan. At least in the basic example case, ghata I do not know, which is there in right in front of my eyes. I close my eyes, I have to open my eyes, I have to use my chakshur indriya to connect with the ghata so that I have prama about that ghata, and said I am the pramata now. This pramata me does not know this ghata. So I have ghata ajnana at least, ghata avidyavan aham. And avidyavan aham itself is an adhyasa. Because my swarupa is what? My swarupa is jnana swarupa. That chaitanya swarupa me cannot be having avidya. So avidyavan aham, even not in the case of ghata, in case of anything, if I say I do not have a specific knowledge, I have avidya regarding that specific object, that is fine. But to consider that I have avidya regarding myself also, why? Because I am not purna, I want some knowledge, I consider myself as an individual pramata. That itself shows avidyavanaham is an adhyasa. So adhyasatmaka pramatra, pramata, being a pramata itself is an adhyasa. So adhyasatmaka pramatra ashritatvat, since the pramana prameya vyavahara is possible, pramana is there in this pramata, they all rest upon pramata, all of these have dependency on pramata, who himself is adhyasta. The very nature of pramata is chaitanya swarupa brahmatma, but who considers himself as a pramata. Therefore, that itself is adhyasa. So adhyasatmaka pramata is who? Pramatra is adhyasa atmaka. Adhyasa atma swarupa swarupam yasya pramatuhu sap pramata adhyasatmaka pramata. So adhyasatmaka pramatra is an ashraya. For whom? For all of these. Pramana, prameya, vyavahara, all of these. Those are the hetus, but for them to function, prama, vyavahara, hetu for prama, to work, pramana should be there, that pramana, vyavahara which should will take place based on this fellow who is a pramata. That pramata is avidyavan, therefore, that is an adhyasa, and adhyasatmaka pramatra ashritatvat, pramayaha api, this prama which is hetu bhuta. For vyavahara of prameya, pramana prameya vyavahara, for that prama is hetu bhuta, and that is also resting in whom? It is resting in this, it is ashrita in this pramatru. Pramatru happens to be adhyasatmaka avidyavan. Therefore, this prama being, prama will take place in a pramatru. Pramatru is an adhyasa, arthadhyasa, and considering myself as pramata is a jnanadhyasa. So this adhyasa is there, it's anubhava siddha. Where will the pramana rest now? Pramana cannot be elsewhere. Prameya is in front of my eyes. Prama will take place in me, the pramata. And pramana cannot be elsewhere. Pramana has to be in me. Pramana, my pramana has to work there. My chakshurindriya should connect with ghata for me to know the ghata. Have the ghata jnana. Your pramana, your chakshurindriya will not work for me. So pramana is also resting in this pramata, me. So pramana naam avidyavad vishayatvam yadyapi pratyaksham. This pramana will also rest in me. And resting in me who I am avidyavan, therefore I am the ashraya, vishaya meaning ashraya. So therefore, pramanas also have what? Avidyavad vishayatvam. Pramananam avidyavad vishayatvam. Avidyavan aham pramata aham. Avidyavan pramata aham ashrayaha vishayaha ashraya yesham pramananam. Those pramana also are avidyavad vishaya vishayani, and therefore they have avidyavad vishayatvam. Yadyapi pratyaksham, this is pratyaksha siddha to me. Tathapi, even then, punarapi katham kena pramanena avidyavad vishayatvam iti yojana. So Purvapakshi is asking, but still you tell me with another pramana, although it is pratyaksha siddha, you tell me how is this so? How is avidyad vishayatvam for pramanas that you are talking about? Pramana, shastras, laukika, vyavahara, vaidika vyavahara, All the Shastra Vyavahara also you are saying they are avidyavad vishaya. Please explain how. So, although it is Pratyaksha Siddha, how is it Pratyaksha Siddha? It has been explained. Because this Pramata who is himself an Adhyasa, considering oneself as Pramata is an Adhyasa, and all these Pramanas work for this fellow, all the Prameyas is what you are dealing with. All the Vyavahara need Prameya, and without Pramanas they are not possible. I am a Pramata, so Pramana, Prameya, Pramatru, Vyavahara is a Triputi. That Triputi is understood by everyone. So where will the Pramanas rest? Pramanas will rest in you. You, considering yourself as Pramata, is an Adhyasa, dealing with a Prameya outside or inside, and this Pramana is also resting in you. You yourself are Avidyavan, Adhyasavan, therefore these Pramanas are also in you as Adhyasa Vishaya. They are also Avidyavad Vishaya. You are the Ashraya for them. You are the Vishaya. You are the Ashraya for them. Pramanas, for those Pramanas also. Therefore, they are Avidyavad Vishaya. This is Pratyaksha Siddha. Still, he is asking, give me another Pramana. So, it's a little complicated samasa. And the Vyakhyana is also in such a... Because Vishaya is a different interpretation here. So, I overshot time. यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदराप महत्पदं तमामाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजाङ्गमनन्त सुखाकृतिं. एनी क्वेश्चंस?
नमस्ते.